Hello, Capricorn. Welcome to your monthly tarot reading. This is for the month of February. For Capricorn, sun, moon, or rising, you might be watching all three of those to gain more insight into what the month has in store for you. I'm going to begin with the Work Your Light Oracle, and then I'm laying down the Muse Tarot. We're going to see what Spirit wants Capricorn to know for this month. What is coming in for Capricorn? If you like the reading, do me a favor. Hit that like button. Share it with your friends. Leave me a comment. And of course, you can hit that subscribe button or that notification bell. Spirit, what do we have for Capricorn, please? What do we have for Capricorn? Messages for Capricorn. Unbound, unbound. Releasing soul patterns, contracts, and past lives. It's all about freeing yourself up this month, freeing yourself from those things that keep you tethered, that hold you back. I like that. you want to keep moving forward. Release those old patterns that no longer serve you. Those old habits, perhaps, that keep you tethered. Time to release them. All right. Here we have. We are starting out with Muse of Emotions. Muse of Emotions. In touch with your emotions. Get in touch with those emotions, how you feel about things. It's going to help move you forward. And then we have the Eight of Inspiration. Lovely. Things falling into place. There's movement headed in the right direction. Things are being laid out for you. There's movement, making progress. The Eight of Emotions now, leaving behind what no longer serves you. Releasing those past influences, those things that no longer serve you. Continuing to move forward. What else do we have here, please? The Nine of Inspiration, following those passions. She doesn't look tired at all to me. Following your inspirations, passions. Look at the orange. This is a creative energy. What else do we have here? We have the World, Cosmos. Wow. So things are opening up for you, opportunities presenting themselves. This is an opportunity to move forward. The possibilities are endless there. Be open to all possibilities. Let's see what else we have. Nine of Emotions now. Wow. Look at that. In touch with your feelings. What brings you that inner fulfillment, that inner joy? Where is your bliss? You've got two eights here, two nines here. Things are moving. All right, what else do we have here? We have the Strength. tapping into your inner strength, your resiliency, going within and finding that strength that you need to continue to move forward, to move on, to deal with anything that arises and overcome it and keep moving forward. Then we have the Seven of Voices. Gain clarity, wisdom, know your next move, contemplate your next move, gather any information that you need to gather to move forward in intellect, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Okay, we have coming out here the Nine of Materials, another nine materials, independence. There's three nines out here already, and there are three eights out here. This is insane. Wow. And then the Page of Materials. So, yeah, this month, it's all about you. It's all about that inner work, establishing who you are, what you want, what you need to deal with, what you need to do to move forward. Take the opportunity, this Page of Materials. What do you need to do for your future? To invest in yourself and your own well-being. What else do we have here? The Lovers. Interesting. I love the lotus flowers here, the indicating peace. And there's two. We'll have to see what transpires with that one when we clarify. The Lovers, a partnership. There could be somebody coming in toward the end of the month. I don't know. We'll see. Ace of Inspiration, yes. Moving forward, that new beginning, following your passions, your desires, your inspirations. What are you inspired to do, to pursue, to create? At the bottom of the deck, the Ace of Emotions, the new beginning emotionally. A lot of inner work, delving within this month by the look of it. Let's see what we have here coming out. We have the Two of Cups. Okay. Yep. All right, we have on the Muse of Emotions here, we have the Knight of Cups. We have the Two of Cups. So there could be somebody pouring their heart out to you, somebody seeking a little bit more in a relationship, getting in touch with your inner feelings, your emotions on the situation, knowing what you want. Be open to what this person has to say. And we have the Nine of Wands. She's tired. She's fought the good fight. Look at this. Her wands are all fizzled out. She's bandaged. She's backed up against a tree, exhausted. Is that the way you feel in this relationship? Or perhaps that's the way you feel before this pouring out comes in. Not sure. Let's see. Did I have any other cards coming up here? No. All right, let's see if I can get some more clarity on this one. Anything more on this one, please? Come on, cards. Anything more on this one? Okay. The Page of Swords. Messages. Clear messages. And this is in the reverse. This is the Fool in the reverse. Now, the Fool in the upright is all about taking that opportunity, setting out on the new adventure, leaping forward in faith, believing in the reverse. Maybe you don't believe that this relationship, partnership, whatever it is, you don't believe in it. You're not willing to trust it, to take the leap of faith, whatever the part. It doesn't have to be a love relationship. I mean, it could be somebody wanting to share their feelings with you, to partner up with you, to accomplish something together, not necessarily a love relationship, but perhaps you're a little wary, cautious. Or you're being told to be cautious in the situation. But I see this Eight of Inspiration here. I see things moving forward. Forward movement in the right direction. So perhaps it's your own fears, your own limiting beliefs about a situation, your own distrust that is holding you back. Maybe you've been hurt in the past and you're afraid to take that leap of faith, to take that risk. Let's clarify this Eight of Inspirations, please. Wow, okay. Whoa. okay. The two queens, the Queen of Wands and the Queen of Swords, balance out your energy. Don't get too caught up in your head. Be willing to listen to your heart as well. Sometimes we get too analytical. And we miss what the heart is trying to tell us. We have the Three of Wands. I'm sorry, the Four of Wands. Celebration, gathering with friends and family. But it was more indicating a reversal situation. Maybe you need to seek out that support where you're not seeking it out. We have the Page of Wands here. Yes, that heartfelt. What path are you going to follow? Are you going to listen to your heart's guidance? Or are you going to get too analytical? You get in touch with your emotions here with this Eight of Emotions. How do you feel? What needs to be released? What do you need to walk away from in order to move forward, in order to embrace your future? Let's see what we have here. Oops. What? All right, I know one flipped here. Here it is. Take a time of rest for contemplation, for recovery, for self-healing. And then we have the Eight of Pentacles in the reverse and the Six of Wands in the reverse. Your hesitation and reluctance to release will hold you back from success. Be willing to commit to freeing yourself, healing yourself, working through those things that hold you back so that you can move forward. Be willing to put in the work. Yeah, we have the Tower jumping out here for the Knight of Inspirations. Tower on the Knight of Inspirations. You're tired. But there is change coming in. This is could be unexpected, or this could be change that you yourself are implementing as you're going through this process. Don't be afraid to release those things that stand in your way. Those old beliefs, those old patterns, ways of doing things that are holding you back. Be open to messages of love, of shared dreams, messages from spirit, opportunities to move forward. Look at this, the Queen of Pentacles. Be courageous enough to move forward. Know that you are taken care of. Nurture yourself. Your inner garden. You are provided for. Trust. Let's see what the we have for the world cosmos here, please. Okay. Wow. Okay. We have the Five of Wands, challenges. We have the High Priestess, yeah. Use your intuition. Get in touch with that intuition, your higher self. Connect with that higher wisdom that you have. You have that within you. Connect to that higher understanding to overcome the obstacles. We have the Queen of Cups here, but it's in the reverse. Don't be controlled by your emotions. We have the Star, but again, it's in the reverse. Don't be afraid to take the opportunity to follow the dream, the desire, the wish. I get this sense that it's fear that holds you back because of past experiences and influences. And there's a need to work through that. Okay, Nine of Emotions, yeah. To find out, to discover what it is you desire, what brings you that inner fulfillment. We have the Devil, but the devil is not in the upright. It is in the reverse. Don't let anything hold you captive anymore. Set yourself free from any illusions of being stuck, being bound. Look at this. The Knight of Wands and the Ace of Pentacles. Take the opportunity that's presenting itself. Listen to that heart's guidance. Move in the direction your heart is leading you. Take advantage of the opportunities before you. Plant those seeds. Nurture those seeds. You have the resiliency within you to deal with these things. You have what you need. You have the inner strength to face your inner challenges, outward challenges, all of it. You have what you need. See, we have the Two of Pentacles. Keep things balanced. Weigh your decisions, choices. Weigh things in the balance here. It's also about balancing your energies, your time, your resources. And the Hierophant, get in touch with that, again, that higher self. gain some higher perspective and understanding. The only way to do that is to connect with yourself. Do that inner work, that connect with your emotions, your feelings, your heart, your higher self. What is spirit telling you? What messages are you getting from your higher self? Spend some time in meditation this month and going deep within, discovering what you need to work on. Look at that. The six, and that will take you to your success with the Six of Pentacles. Yeah. Find that balance, that equal give and take, that reciprocal energy. There should be a balance in your life. Don't be ruled by past experiences. Don't be ruled by emotions, by limiting beliefs. Find that balance. Let's see, we have the Seven of Voices here. Let me have here. Okay. And we have another seven, two sevens here. This is the seven, the Chariot, meaning the opportunity providing itself here for you to move forward in the desired direction. Listen to that intelligence, the clarity that's coming in. Gather your wisdom and choose wisely the direction that you want to move in. Oops, I have something flipped here. All right. First this one. The Hanged Man. Take the time that you need. Gain perspective, wisdom, and understanding. Decide which direction you want to move in, and then take that opportunity to move forward. Look, the Three of Wands. You're heading in a new direction. Very exciting. Very exciting. The Five of Cups. Don't, for some reason, cry over spilt milk just came into my head, which is totally strange. release. Release. Don't dwell on past experiences, past losses, the things that have been left behind. There is a table of bounty behind her with cups. There's a basket here. There's plenty of food. There's balloons. There's a celebration behind her. Don't dwell on the loss. Gain perspective, insight, and know your next move. Figure out the direction you want to move in. This is an opportunity to move forward in something that you really, really want, long for, desire. We have the Nine of Materials here. Yes, independence there. Be bold. Be courageous. Exercise your independence here. Pursue the dream. Oh my goodness. Okay. Create that harmony and balance there with the Six of Cups, the Ten of Wands. It's time to lay down that heavy burden. You're at the end of the road here. The work, you've put in so much work. You've labored so hard. And now you're coming to the end, the time to lay down that burden. We have the Three of Pentacles, possible collaboration with others. And the Nine of Swords. The Nine of Swords. You got to stay out of your head and not worry. Take the opportunity to collaborate with others, to team up with others, to lighten your load. Create that harmony and balance, that, again, reciprocal energy, equal give and take. It's handing flowers off to her, giving, find that balance, that harmony. That perfect place where your energies, your resources, everything is in balance. We have the Page of Materials here. Investing in your future, your well-being, perhaps. This is all about you moving forward, taking the opportunity, the Emperor taking your power back, stepping into your power and your authority, the King of Swords in the reverse, but you're doing it without indifference, without cutting anybody out, and not losing sight of your passions. You're listening to the intellect here, but not ruled by that cold intellect. It's not cold and indifferent. Okay. The Eight of Cups, look at that. It's in the reverse this time. You've left it behind. Wow. Because in the upright, it's all about leaving it behind. Walking away from what no longer serves you in the reverse. You've already done it, perhaps, and it's time to move on because we addressed that up there. We have the King of Pentacles, abundant. We have the Ten of Cups. It looked more to be in the reverse. Oh, and this is the Lover's card. Perhaps there's a new love opportunity coming in. King of Pentacles, earthy energy. Not sure here. This Ten of Cups is in reverse. In the upright, it's all about that happy home life, fulfillment, abundance, overflow. And now it's not there. So perhaps whoever this new person is, this King of Pentacles energy, this earth sign, it could be an earth sign. Of course, I don't know. You have a lot here. perhaps it's not. Let's see what else we have. Let's clarify some more. Ace of Cups. Oh, perhaps it is a new emotional beginning. New emotional beginning, the Ace of Cups. But we have the Ten of Cups in reverse. Interesting. The potential is there. Maybe not with this person, though. Maybe it's something you need to create on your own first. Let's clarify this Ace of Inspiration here, this opportunity. Okay. Seven of Wands. Holding your ground. What is it you desire? What is it you believe? What is it you want to go after? What are your boundaries that you've set? You need to hold to them. You need to stand up for yourself. We have the Hermit here. Time of reflection, inner reflection, contemplation, connecting with the higher self, higher understanding. And we have the Four of Cups here. You don't want to miss the opportunities presenting themselves because you're caught up in the past. Don't allow the past to keep you from your dream. Do not allow the past to keep you from your dream. Let's take another, see if we have any more clarifiers here. Any more clarifiers for this Ace of Inspiration? Oh, look at that. All right, here we go. The Nine of Cups, yes. Go within, find out how you feel about things, do that inner searching, And then we have the Wheel of Fortune in the reverse. In the reverse. Wheel of Fortune is usually a new cycle beginning or something like that. So you can't do that until you deal with all of this. If you want to move forward, you must do the inner work. You must release that old stuff. This is an inner transformation occurring for you this month, Capricorn. Look at, we have Judgment on the bottom of the deck. Yes, it's discovering your truth, gaining clarity on who you are, what you want, what direction you want to move in, and honoring that, honoring that. Let me, pulling right a look at this. Jumping right out at us is surrender to the sweetness. Venus energy, pleasure, joy, make love to life. Do that inner reflection, that deep inner work. Discover who you are. Take the time to know yourself, to know what you want, and to take pleasure in the journey, in the discovery. I mean, enjoy life. And our rune is Algis. Opportunity. Do the inner work. Know that you're protected. Opportunities are coming in for you. You're protected from the negative events as you do this inner journey, this inner transformation. You're being watched over. You're being protected. Move forward and don't fear. Don't fear the journey. Don't fear your own feelings and the inner work. This is what I have for you, Capricorn. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a blessed month.